Hi, everyone. Zach here with Cornerstone Solutions. Here at Cornerstone, when we send out a proposal to our clients, we give them three options of service, A, B, and C, and we let them choose which option works the best for them. I have a lot of clients that ask us to replicate that in their own CRM, and today I'm going to show you how to do that. Let's take a look. Okay, so there's a couple of different ways you could go about this. In our CRM, we have a completely custom module called Proposals that we use to issue our proposals. It's because it has a lot of fields on it. We want to keep it separate from other modules. So we made a completely new custom module. You could also add this to your deal module. If you don't have a lot of fields on your deal module, maybe you have space on the deal module to do your proposals, you could do it in that module as well. So it kind of depends on your use case. For today's demonstration, I'm just going to go ahead and use the deal module since it's already in place, and it'll make it a little bit easier for our demonstration. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to click on setup here, and I'm going to click on modules and fields, and I'm going to select the deal module and the standard layout. Okay, so I've got all my typical fields that I have on a deal record, and then I'm going to grab a subform here, and I'm going to drop it down at the bottom of the record, and I'm just going to call this proposal. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to add a field in here, and we're just going to add a single line field, and we're going to call this task. Okay, and this is just going to be a brief label of the task that we're going to complete for the person. Then I'm going to add another field. We're going to do a multi-line field this time, and we're going to call this description. Okay, then I'm going to add a pick list field. And this is going to be my pick list where I specify which option that I want to list this particular task under in the proposal. So I'm going to have three different options, A, B, and C. So I'm going to call this field option. And then I'm just going to rename these A, B, option C. Okay. And then I'm going to, it looks like I had made a proposal subform before, so I'm just going to relabel this one real quick so that it lets me save the record. I'm going to add one more field here to my subform, and that is going to be a currency field because I want to specify on my proposal how much that particular task is costing. So I'm going to go ahead and cost here and go ahead and save this record. Okay, now that we've got our subform added to the deal module, we need to create a mail merge template so that we can have a proposal to actually generate for the client. So I'm going to cancel out of this and I'm going to go back to setup and I'm going to choose templates and I'm going to go to mail merge templates. And I'm going to click new template here. And I'm going to select the deal module. And we're going to call it proposal. And I'll create this. Okay, this is going to push you over to Zoho Writer. Zoho Writer is what is used to create all these mail merge documents. And so you can dress this document up however you want. You can add images into it and all kinds of information about your company and stuff like that. On our proposal, we have a 20-page proposal. And so we have a lot of information about us, about Zoho, about our process, things like that. You can add all of that stuff into your proposal here so that you don't have to generate it each time. It just auto-generates. But today I'm going to mainly just show you how to separate out the different tasks into the options that you specify for those tasks. So I'm just going to kind of brush over a lot of the other things in the creation of this today. So just give it a name real quick. And what I want to do is I'm going to come here to the automate section and we want to grab the subform. So under manage fields, we have subforms and you can see that I have this proposal module, proposal subform here that I want to add into the proposal. Okay, so there's a bunch of different fields. Obviously, I've got my task field that I want to include. I've got the description field. I've got the cost field, and then there's the option field, but I don't actually want to include this in here, but I'll show you what I'm going to do with that later. I don't want to actually show this on the report. I'm gonna show you how to handle this in a second here. Okay, so I select my task description cost, and then I click insert as, and I want to do repeat as table rows. And so for all the options that we have, we want to repeat every task in that option as a table row. So I'm gonna select that. All right, so I've created the first one here. I'm gonna go ahead and label this option A. Okay, now, next step is important. So what I wanna do here is I've got my subform, and you can see here, it's labeled task, description, cost, and then underneath it are the merge tags for those subform fields. And so what I wanna do is I'm gonna click on the table itself, and you can see that when I click on the table, I can then click on the different rows or columns. They're labeled here. So I'm just gonna click on the second row. Okay, and when I do that, over here on the left-hand side under advanced merge fields, I have conditions. And so I'm gonna click condition, and I'm gonna add in the condition for this row that the option selected is A. So in this particular case, you could do is option A. In this, what I'm gonna do, I'll just do that, is option A, and we're gonna insert that. Okay. So then obviously we're gonna need an option B and option C, so we'll do that real quick here. Okay, so again, under option B, I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna add my subform in here, proposals, I want the task, description, and cost. We're going to insert as, repeat as table rows. Okay, then I'm going to select row number two here. Again, I'm going to click condition. And for option, this time we're going to do option B. And then one last time here under option C. And we're gonna insert this. Okay, so there's one other thing that I wanna show you before I go ahead and save this template. And that's in each one of these options, I wanna show a total cost for that particular option. And so there's a number of ways you could do this, but I'm just gonna do it the simple way. I'm gonna add a row at the bottom of each option, and I just wanna sum up the total cost of all of the tasks within that particular option. So again, I'm gonna select the table, select row number two here. I'm going to add a row after row number two down here at the bottom. And then I'm going to go right underneath the proposal cost here. And I'm just going to click on that cell. And then I'm going to click on the formula button that pops up on this menu to the side. And then it just automatically says sum above. And so we would just want to sum the fields that are above this particular one. And I'm going to insert that. And I'm going to do that for all of these options down here. I'm just going to add another row, click into this field. We're going to click formula, sum above, insert, and for option C as well. Okay, and what this will do is once we create our proposal and we merge it into this document, it will put a total cost for each one of the options underneath the options so people can see what the total cost of that is. Okay, so there's one thing I wanted to show before I move on and we actually do a merge into the proposal here. So as you can see, I kind of dressed up the proposal a little bit, put some colors in it. I changed around the formulas in these different options. What I wanted to do is in our proposal, you have option A, and then in option B includes everything in option A plus option B, and then C includes everything in A and B plus the stuff that's in C. And so these costs, instead of just being a total of the options that are in that particular section, like option A totaling all of the option A, option B totaling all the option B, I want the option B total cost to total everything in B plus what everything in A was. Same thing with option C. I want the total cost to be everything that's in C plus B and A. So what I did was I edited these formulas, and you can see here that the formula now is everything below this, and then in option B, it's everything in table one, and then cell C1 right here. And same thing down here, then everything in below and everything that's the total of table two C1. So these should be cumulative totals that are displayed here. I also just changed the size of the table fields around so that it displayed a little better, but I just wanted to show you that before we went on to the next step here. Okay, now that we have our template completely set up, I went ahead and took the liberty of creating a deal record and inputting some information into this proposal subform here. So I've got a number of different tasks and descriptions, and you can see in each one of the lines, I have them selected for which option that I want them in. So the top three here are option A, then I've got some for option B, option C. They all have costs associated with them. So the last step in this process is actually merging this into the document. And so I'm going to go ahead up here to the top right-hand corner and click the little ellipsis and then select mail merge. And it's the proposal template, so that's already selected. I'm going to hit merge. Okay, so it's going to open up a writer document. It's going to say, okay, here's your template. And then all you have to do down here at the bottom is just click a run merge down in the bottom left-hand corner. Pops up with a little pop-up screen that shows you where the document is going to save. So I have the saving to work drive into a general folder. And so I'm just going to hit create here. Okay, and it's going to give me a log. And it takes about, I don't know, a minute to merge this document. And you can just hit the refresh button up here when it's done. So our merge document is complete. I'm in Zoho Work Drive. Here's the proposal document. I'm going to go ahead and open this up. And it looks great. We have our different tasks separated out into the different options. I had three tasks in option A, total of $950. That totals up here at the top. Two tasks in option B, total of $1,250. That plus what was in option A gives us a total of $2,200. Two tasks in option C, giving us for a total of 2,000, giving us a total in option C of 4,200. So everything laid out exactly the way that we wanted it to. And we were able to create our multi-line proposal here. So hopefully this video has been helpful for you, showed you how to create the subform in the deals module, also showed you how to structure the merge template with the different tables that were filtered for the different options. Now you can take these skills and you can create your own multi-option proposal. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.